Hello everyone, welcome to part 2 of lesson 3, Properties of Natural Resources. In part 1, we have learned about air as a natural resource. Today, we will learn about water and soil. Now, water. Properties of water. Water is a fluid substance that is found in liquid state at room temperature and at ordinary conditions. Water has its volume, but it does not have its own shape. When water freezes into ice, it expands and its volume increases. Solid ice becomes lighter than original liquid water, and hence ice floats on water. Next property of water is density. The interrelation between the volume and mass of the substance, the space occupied by the substance is its volume. And the store of matter in a substance is its mass. Therefore, density is mass upon volume. Mass divided by volume. Mass is measured in grams and volume in cubic centimeters. Therefore, or hence, density is equal to mass divided by volume, that is gram divided by centimeter cube. Density of water. If the mass of 1 liter of water is 1 kg, that is 1000 gram, and volume of water is 1 centimeter cube, then density of water is 1. Density of water is 1. Next, anomalous behavior of water. When water at normal temperature starts cooling, its density increases like that of most of liquids. However, if its temperature falls below 4 degrees centigrade, its density starts decreasing. This means that the density of water is maximum at temperature 4 degree centigrade. If the temperature of water is lower below 4 degree centigrade, its density decreases and volume increases. It means that water expands when the temperature falls below 4 degree centigrade. This is called anomalous behavior of water. Now, uses of water according to its properties. First property of water is fluidity. In generator to generate electricity. Second property, good coolant. That property used in motor vehicles to control the temperature of the engine as a function. Next property is universal solvent. Water is a universal solvent, and that property used in factories, laboratories, foodstuffs, and in various types of biological process of the body. And next property of water is cooling agent. We use water as a cooling agent for bathing, cleaning, and washing clothes. Next natural resource is a soil. Properties of soil. Color. First property is color. The soil gets its color as a result of several processes. Soil may be in black, red, and copper yellow and gray color. These colors of soil are useful in its classifications. Properties like fertility, drainage of water, capacity to hold water depends upon its color of the soil. The color of the soil depends upon its structures, its organic ingredients, and chemical ingredients like iron and lime. Now, soil structures. Soil structures depends upon the proportion of the particles of various sizes in it. Now, first type of soil structure is sandy soil. The proportion of large particles of the sand is more. Through such soil, water drains rapidly. Plowing of this soil is easy. Soil is less fertile. Particles are made of the silicon dioxide that is called quartz. These particles are insoluble in water, therefore the soil supplies less nutrients. Second type of soil structure is silt soil. The particles are of medium size. Silt soil is not easily plowable. Containing the large proportion of organic materials, good capacity to supply nutrients, therefore are also called sedimentary soil. Next type of soil structure is clay soil. The proportion of the small particles is maximum. Difficult to plow the soil. The particles of this soil are smooth to touch, has a high water holding capacity. These are the properties of soil structures according its nutrients and capacity of holding water. Next is now soil structure and importance of soil. First, structure. Structure of soil occurs in the form of columnar, laminar, granular as as well as block shape structures. This structure depends upon the different shapes of the particles in it. As shown in figure, we see that these types of structure of soil. And the fertility of soil depends upon the soil structure. The advantages of good soil structure are as follows. Roots are supplied with good amount of oxygen, good water drainage, good growth of plant roots. Now, uses of soil. Plant conservation, water conservations, using characteristics of plasticity, different articles of soils are made. Some useful types of soil. First type of soil is China clay. We call as kaolin. It is used in crockery, bathroom tiles, tanks, laboratory apparatus, plus jars. In this figure, these are laboratory apparatus, jars, and flasks. Second one is shadow soil. It is used as statues and idols. We use shadow soil used in idols. Terracotta soil. Decorative articles and pots used for growing plants. And Multani soil is used in cosmetics. Testing of soil. The proportion of the various ingredients of soil can be determined by soil testing. Soil testing to find out if there is a deficiency of any ingredients and to decide what measures should be taken to remove the deficiency. Danish scientist Sorensen put forth the concept of pH of soil based on the concentration of hydrogen ions in the soil. Accordingly, soil may be found to be one of the following three types. Acidic soil, if pH is less than 6.5, then that soil is acidic soil. Neutral soil, its pH range is 6.5 to 7.5. Alkaline soil, pH higher than 7.5. Causes of diminished soil fertility. Soil pH less than 6 or higher than 8. Low proportion of organic matter. No proper drainage of water. Repeated cultivation of the same crop and continuous use of saline water and excessive use of chemical fertilizers and pesticides. These are the causes of diminished soil fertility.